Belief in Qiyamah, what else does it do? It motivates us to live. It motivates us to accomplish something. It motivates us to have a purpose in life, a meaning in life. When you don't believe in a Qiyamah, when you don't believe in God, life becomes meaningless, really. What's the purpose of living? What is the whole goal? And of course, one of the first philosophers to point out this contradiction, who himself, they say, was an atheist, was Nietzsche, the famous German philosopher who went mad at the end of his life, the famous philosopher who was one of the first to publicly proclaim he was an atheist. By the way, atheism is a very, very modern phenomenon. In the history of mankind, you will not find atheists up until 200 years ago. It's a very recent phenomenon as we understand it. And even 200 years ago, it was just a handful of people. Only the last century, and especially the last half century, is when atheism has spread like wildfire. That's another interesting topic. The first famous philosopher, really, to come out and just deny God outright is Nietzsche. In his famous passage, the infamous passage, A'udhu Billah, the death of God, and we have killed God and whatnot. But even in that passage, when you read it in the Enlightened Science, he actually mentions in there the parable of the group of people who, it's a parable, it's a metaphor, that they believe they have killed God. Nietzsche says that, do you not realize that in killing God you have killed yourselves? This is what Nietzsche himself writes. Like you think you've killed the idea of God. There's no God left. There's no idea is gone. When you extinguish the idea of God, Nietzsche is saying, you have extinguished your own existence. Life becomes meaningless. And then he writes in his philosophical way, now up is down and down is up. Dark is light, light is dark. Meaning, everything is gone. There's nothing to anchor you to anything. Morality is gone, which we see right now, right? What was khabith and well known to be wrong yesterday is now embraced as being pure and whatnot. Everything is gone, up for grabs. Once you remove God from the picture, not only morality, your existence. And I have to say this, and it's a bit sensitive to say, but I try to put gentle here. We are witnessing the rise of a wave of mental disorders and depression, the likes of which have never ever occurred in human history. Even when I was growing up, teenagers did not undergo depression at the rates we're seeing now. Young men and women who have their whole lives ahead of them. And now if you look at it, every psychiatry journal is talking about it. The rise of meaninglessness in life. Young men and women have to go to a psychiatrist, to a shrink, to a therapist, take medication. Not that I'm saying it's wrong necessarily, but we have to ask ourselves, here's the blunt question, why? Why is there this influx of suicides? A very sensitive topic, and may Allah protect all of us. But never in human history have young men and women been committing suicide at the rates we see in this generation. And the way things are heading, it will get worse. A'udhu billah, a'udhu billah. It's going to get worse. But why? Why is there rates of depression? Why? To us it is self-evident. When you remove God, and you remove religion, and you remove an akhirah, life becomes meaningless. Pointless. What's the point of living when you're just going to have to face one struggle and one pain and one rejection and one love this and what? What's the point? When in the end you're just going to be extinguished anyway, you might as well extinguish yourself now and save yourself the hassle of all that's going to happen. And so when you believe in a qiyamah, believe it or not, it makes you alive inside. Makes your life worthwhile and meaningful. That's the second point. The third point, linked to the second one, not only does it make your life worthwhile, it gives you a sense of optimism in that the future will be better than the past. And this is explicit in the second or third revelation. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. It's explicit in the Quran. Whatever happens in this dunya, you have something to look forward to. You know, this is human nature. Like if you're having a tough year, but you know that, let's say in the corporation, in the corporate year, and it's a tough year, but you know there's a raise coming in December. You know you're going to get your nice fat check in December. You're like, okay, you know what? I'll just work until December. I'll get my rewards. It gives you encouragement, right? It gives you optimism that whatever's happening in the corporate politics, I have something to look forward to. Allah is saying, don't worry about this dunya. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرُ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Life is indeed very difficult. Let's be honest here. It can be very depressing. There's a lot of things that happen that really affects us. But the future is brighter for the believer. And when the believer believes in Qiyamah, it gives a sense of peace that, you know what? The Akhirah will be better for me. So it makes a person optimistic. And this is what our Prophet ﷺ said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٍ. Wondrous are the affairs of the believer. For no matter what happens to the believer is a winner. How would the believer be a winner? Because he believes in an Akhirah. If there was no Akhirah, this life truly, truly can be interpreted to be a losing battle all the time.